time is it? Oh, good morning, children. Welcome to another edition of Kids City Online with City Baptist. Yay! We're so happy you're joining us today. I am Mr. Honeytwinkle. I think you may be thinking he looks familiar. Well, in one of our episodes last season, you met my wife, Mrs. Honeytwinkle. She is so lovely, isn't she? Oh, she is the cutest thing in the world. I could tell you the story of how God placed her in my life and then we lived happily ever after, but I don't have enough time today. Today, we need to get ready for church, people. We all know we're going to sing a song of worship, we're going to learn a lesson, and this week we have a very, very, very special teacher. You may remember him from a long time ago because it's been over a year since we've seen him. It is Mr. Tim. Yay, Mr. Tim. We missed you so much. He will be bringing your lessons this Sunday. So kids, let's get ready to worship. Everybody be standing on your feet because you're singing to the Lord. Nobody lays in their bed or sits on the couch. Let's stand up and let's get ready to worship. Okay, let's do it!
The splendor of a king, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide. And trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great is our God. Godhead three in one, How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great is our God. How great is our God?
Wow, great job singing so far, children. You know, I've heard such great things about you from my wife, Miss Honey Twinkle. You know, her and Miss Linda, one of your teachers, are very close friends. In fact, they're a big reason why we're together today. You see, one day, Miss Honey Twinkle was helping Miss Linda shop for some groceries, and that's when Oh, I told you I would not tell you the story because there's just not enough point. So, right, where were we? Oh, yes, okay, back to the lesson. Now, before we hear from today's teacher, Mr. Tim, I hope, and I really, really, really hope that one of you remembers the Bible verse from last week. If you remember, we were in Hebrews 11, verse 1, and it read, "Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen." Now, I hope you guys are learning these Bible verses because they're very, very important. I'm excited now. I can't wait to hear today's story and the lesson from Mr. Tim. So, please sit back, pay attention, and enjoy, children.
In King David's time, the Ark of the Covenant, which was a great golden chest that held the Ten Commandments and represented God's presence among the Israelites, had been held captive by the Philistines. King David gathered all his soldiers and all the people of Israel to rescue the Ark of the Covenant from enemy hands. As they returned to Jerusalem, the great crowd of people danced with joy and sang songs of praise to God. Years after bringing the Ark of the Covenant back to Jerusalem, God gave King David peace from all his enemies. In awe of all the Lord had done for him, King David decided to build the Lord a temple. But because King David had been a man of war, God came to the prophet Nathan and told him that King David would not be the one to build this amazing temple. Instead, God said that King David's son Solomon would build him a temple, and that God would set up an eternal dynasty through the lineage of King David. As King David came to the end of his life, he made preparations for Solomon to build the temple. King David had great ships bring logs of cedar wood from foreign lands, and he had tons of stone carved from distant mountains brought to Jerusalem. He ordered iron and more bronze than could be weighed to make nails and other fittings for the great temple. King David gathered the leaders of Israel together and told them to support Solomon so he would be successful in this great task. For more than 7 years, Solomon embarked upon the great work of building the temple. When it was finished, it stood 4 stories tall and 9 feet long. The interior of the building was completely covered in cedar wood, decorated with beautiful carvings of fruit and open flowers. The walls of the inner sanctuary, the room where the Ark of the Covenant was housed, were covered in pure gold. Not a single surface of the temple was without decoration. It was a magnificent sight. When the temple was finished, Solomon completed his father's vision and had the Ark of the Covenant brought into the temple. As Solomon and the elders of Israel watched, a procession of priests carried the Ark into the temple. Once it had been placed upon the altar in the inner sanctuary, a great cloud appeared as the glory of the Lord filled the temple. The cloud was so thick, the priests could not perform their work. The entire assembly of Israel had gathered for the occasion. After seeing the glory of the Lord fill the temple, Solomon prayed to God, praising his glory and faithfulness. Solomon prayed that God's people would live according to God's word and purposes. Once Solomon had finished praying and blessing all those in attendance, the people celebrated the incredible feat that had been accomplished. The temple had been built, and the glory of the Lord filled the temple. Once the temple construction was completed, the Lord appeared to Solomon. The Lord said, "I have made this temple you built holy by putting my name on it forever." God told Solomon that if he followed him faithfully, as his father David had, his royal line would have no end. God challenged Solomon, as he instructs us all, to follow him faithfully.
Well, hey guys, I'm Tim, and nice to meet you all. I don't really see you, but let's just pretend. So I'll be your teacher for today, and I'm new, so bear with me. But today we'll talk about Solomon's temple, or rather, God's temple that was built by Solomon. So just a recap, David wasn't allowed by God to build a temple because he was a man of war. And I love the attitude of David here, because he submitted to what God wants instead of doing what he wants. David badly wanted to build the temple, but he let God's decision rule over his decision. So David made sure that Solomon would have everything to build the temple. So after all the materials were completed, were gathered, it is now time to build the temple. But why do they need to build a temple? Well, to answer that, we need to go back to the beginning. Long, long time ago, in the beginning, God created the heaven and earth, and also he created Adam and Eve. But Adam and Eve failed to obey God. They sinned. And because of sin, they cannot stay in the presence of God in the Garden of Eden. It was such a nice garden, but they had to leave because God is holy. And being holy means there is no room for sin. That is who God is. God cannot fail nor sin. But God has a plan to restore that so that he can live with us. And one way to do that is when he instructed the nation of Israel to build a place for him where they can give sacrifices. Now, these sacrifices make people feel bad about their sin. Animals had to die because of their failures. But those sacrifices also kept the place holy and clean, you know, so that God's presence can dwell with them. That's why Solomon wanted to build a temple, because this will be the house of God, where God will live or dwell with his people. And that is why it was made with very fine materials. One of them is gold, and gold is expensive. And you know, the Bible also described heaven with streets of gold. Wow, can you imagine that? And also inside the temple, you can see a lot of designs like sculptures and crafts, beautiful flowers and trees. So I think it looks familiar. I think we've seen it somewhere. Maybe Garden of Eden? So let me know what you think. So we see God living with his people through the temple. That's why when Solomon had finished the temple, a huge amount of cloud came down, and that is the presence of God. That is God. That's why people rejoiced and worshiped God, because they saw that God was with them. God is living with them. Well, but what about today? Where is the temple? Where does God dwell? Alright, I'll tell you where. Well, you see, when Jesus Christ came, he became the sacrifice for the sin. Remember that sacrifice and Jesus' sacrifice? And now, if we will trust and believe in him, God promised that he will make us holy like the temple. There will be no more sin. We will be clean. So he can now live within us. Our body will now become the house of the Holy Spirit, of God. So if we want to live with God, then we have to completely trust and believe in Jesus, in everything he said in the Bible, so that our bodies will become a clean and holy temple for God to live in. And that's what Solomon's temple is all about.
Wow! Thank you so much for that, Mr. Tim! Bravo! Spectacular! That was truly stupendous! Well, children, that's all the time we have for today. I hope you had a great time with me, and maybe next time you can meet me and my wife in person. Oh, we will love for that day. You know, every day brings us one closer to being with each other again in person. But until that day, that sweet, 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 glorious day, we say goodbye and see you next time. Have a great week, everybody. Bye.